lovely people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna do a haul. I went to Primark and got me some amazing makeup stuff. It's just makeup based stuff, no clothes or anything, just makeup. And we're gonna look what I bought and then put it on my face. I don't know. Oh, don't take this off. Sorry. I don't know if I'm gonna put one video, a haul and the makeup putting it on, or just a haul and the makeup putting on separately. But yeah, we're gonna look what I've bought, have fun, enjoy yourselves and play with makeup. If you like me, please subscribe to my channel, hit that like button, hit the notifications bell, and yeah, let's have some fun and do some makeup and see what I've got in my goodie bag. We're gonna start with my Demi Matte liquid lipsticks. I went to a Primark with my sister, my little sister, and we looked for a full face of makeup. We've got a full face of Primark makeup, and these are the Demi Matte lipstick in rose. These are four. These are the rose edits. That's what they look like. Then I have a pair of party lashes. These were €2, and the lipsticks were €5 for four. And these are €2, so we have this beautiful. Then we have a foundation. This is the Perfect Finish foundation, and this is in the color Sand, and this was €3. And let's hope, because I bought a close one, because they were all close at our Primark here in the Netherlands. Seems to be okay color, so we'll see how it will work on my skin. Then we've got a eyeshadow palette. This one was €6. It's a neon eyeshadow palette, and it was the green one. They also had other colors. What it looks on the inside. And this is the... This looks quite nice. No, I've never swatched before on my channel, but for everything at first. Yeah. We're gonna play with that later on. Let's go on to the next. Oh, this is a lip gloss, which my sister booked out because she says I have too much of mattes. At least it's for sure. This one hasn't been swatched. Let's open it up. Ooh, I like the sparkle. There it is. That's the lip gloss. Let's go back into the back. I've got myself a brow sketch pencil in the color brown, and this was €2.50. So that took me a while. Let's see. It's brown. Looks okay. Oh, then I got one of the Clento oil balms. This is a cleansing balm for your makeup, because Make Me Up Mista said this is amazing to take your makeup off. So yeah, I would love to try. So I bought one. Then I have my cotton wads. Sorry, I'm not having reusable ones. I just can't get used to it. It doesn't seem to do my skin well if I used reusable, so I'm just to this is for my face and this I use for my eyes. Then I've got a mascara. This is supposed to be a dupe. I think it's in a better than Sex mascara from Too Faced. Oh, pretty packaging. Yeah, I'm gonna try out this one as well. Then of course I've got the Prep and Perfect, so prepping set, and this is a glowy one, so if you shake it you get it nice and glowy. I'm gonna try that one. Then I have a cool eye pencil, and this is a light one. This is for my waterline. This is a nice and beige one. It's called Wide Awake, to open up your eyes. This is what it looks like, the cool eye pencil. Ooh, then we've got the Huda Beauty dupes for the Melted Metal, and this is the Liquid Shadow Duo in Matte and Metallic. Let's see. Well, let's put them right here. Oh, it feels nice. Feels nice on my skin. Let's do the metallic one right next to it. Oh, this is a small pencil. It's pretty. That's big, huge, and this is what it looks like amid a mirror. That's pretty. We've got a diamond bomb highlighter. That looks like this. It's a diamond in a diamond bomb. I've mixed them all together. Let's see. Yeah. Looks like nice. Then I've got myself a foundation pressed powder. We had a translucent powder, but it didn't look so good, so I wanted this, and it's called in the cool sand. Looks really pretty. €2.50. Okay. No, that's okay. It's felt broken, but just has a little bit of up there. This is the concealer stick, medium buildable coverage, natural finish in the color porcelain. They didn't have that many options. Stick. Oh, you just looks light. Let's see what it does on the skin. I don't know, it looks nice, I like it. Then again, Makeup Missa made me buy. She said this was a good, was this one? Yeah, I think so, right? The bronzer, liquid bronzer. The Bronze Whip Velvet Finish Cream Bronzer. Looks like this. And the last, but not least, Bronze Glow Face Bronzer in Glow. And this is also again in one color, which we're gonna clean first with a towel, because it has fingerprints on it, which I didn't notice before, but it has. That's it. That was my haul. And that's all I got. So let's try on all this makeup. Gonna start with the prepping spray. Oh, that's not a nice spray. That's just a flat on spray on. I've got my trusty Uno sponge, because I didn't get any brushes or anything. I'm gonna go in with the foundation. Put something on my makeup tablet, and it looks like very thick, creamy foundation. I just put this on. Smells like foundation. Let's put on all that was on here and see what it does. I didn't go for the matte one. They had also matte that looked like the packaging of the double wear, but I wanted the natural glowy, a bit of perfect finish, but didn't say matte on the back. Looks nicely. I think so. Does it look nice? Not bad, I think. Covers up all my blemishes. Let's see about the coverage. Oh, smack down everything. Medium to full coverage, natural finish, moisturizing, vitamin E, liquid foundation base. Yeah, looks medium to me. I can build it up, so I'm gonna put some of my spots. Go in with my 223 Jessa brush and a little bit of the foundation. And just put it on where I think I need more coverage. It's around this spot, this one, this one, this one, and a little bit more on the bridge of my nose. And just put it in. Feels nice. Looks okay. Does the color? Yeah, it looks like it suits me. Yeah, let's go with the contour with the concealer stick. Never used in a stick. Never used a stick foundation before. Stick foundation. Never used a stick concealer before. I don't know how much to put on. Let's start with that. Oh, that doesn't smell nice. That does not smell nice. Let's see. Going in with the flat side again. Oh, okay. Can you see this? That's not that hard, that easy to blend out. I have to put some pressure on it. Well, I blend it out. Okay, let's go in with our bronze whip. This looks like this. Here I'm gonna go in with my Lux face paint brush, and in my, this is the Lux face from Jessup 109. And just I'm gonna blend this out with my beauty blender, at least that's what I'm planning on. I'm just putting it on now. Because I don't have any contour, I'm gonna use it a little bit under my cheek as well. Under my cheek, under my chin. I'm gonna pat it a little bit more in there. Now I'm gonna go in with a pressed foundation. Not with this thing, but just with the powder brush. Let's do under my eyes first, because it's a lighter shade than my foundation, at least I think so. The bigger brush. This was, by the way, the Lux Face Definer in 101. And now I'm going in with my powder 109. Both are from Jessup. I'm just gonna whirl around and just put this on the rest of my face to set everything in place. Yeah, but it doesn't look cakey. It looks actually quite nice. Really impressed so far by the base brush. Looks nice. Again, I have no contouring palette. Couldn't find one, so I'm now gonna use my bronzer. I wiped this down with a paper towel so that the fingerprints were gone, the dinger and everything. I don't have alcohol, so we'll see. I'm going with my bronzer brush. This is from Essence. Ooh, careful. There's a lot of cake up in a pan. Let's see what it does on my skin. Again, I use this as contour and bronzer, I think. A lot of kick up in the pan, so be careful with it. I'm going back in with the powder, with my powder brush where I did my foundation with, and just go over it a little bit so there's no harsh lines, because I am not using contour, so I think in the bronzer should be soft, I think. Then we're gonna go in with my brush and my blush brush from 127 Jessup. Let's see what this does. Okay. Oh, that's just, look at this pink. It looks so nice. And when you put it on your cheek, I'm using the wrong brush. No, I don't think, but I will see. Let's just try a different brush. Let's go back in with the powder brush. In the middle now. Back in the powder brush. Just a little bit, yeah. Doesn't matter, this was a clean brush, but I figured maybe there was something on from a previous blush, but no, this it just didn't look, doesn't look so pinky in here. It just looks beautiful, and then when you look at the skin, it's so pinky. Not that I mind having it pinky, but yeah, looks different. I expected something else, but it is there. With my highlighter brush, Lux Highlight 105 from Jessup, and the Diamond Bomb. And just try it. Okay. There's an icy highlight. Let's be real. But I don't think they had different colors. But that shine for a €3.50 highlight? Not bad at all. Not bad, I think. So I put my eye base on. And now we're gonna go in with the eyeshadow palette. And I'm just gonna start with the darkest shade. And see how they perform. And I'm going in with a Beauty Bay brush. Okay. Not bad. At least not for the first shade. Nice. Not bad at all. And this for a Primark shadow? I don't know. This was €6. Not bad. Let's blend this out with the middle shade, this one. Again, I'm impressed. I don't mind this. It's good. It's not worse than any of the other shade I used lately from other brands, which... Yeah, well, Beauty Bay was probably not more expensive, but... Okay, but now when I'm blending it, the lighter shade seems to be disappearing. The darker shade seems to be disappearing a little bit, but we'll see what happens when we put the shade back in there. Let's go back in with the darker one, see what happens. Primark, not bad at all. I'm gonna go in with this one and a Morphe M506. I'm not gonna do a weird shape or anything, I'm just trying out the Primark makeup. But yeah, I must say, I am impressed. My whole face, maybe the blush was a little bit off color for me. But I think the foundation looks fine on my skin. Nothing wrong. I color coordinated myself quite good, if I say so myself. Even though the packaging, I looked at the colors and the inside packaging. But then again, I do think I have a normal skin tone, or a normal skin tone, which is bullshit. I do have the regular skin tone that's always in stock and always foundation colors for. I'm not super white, I'm not dark, I'm just in between. For me, lucky, because I always can find a foundation that fits me. I think in every foundation, because the shading sucks, of course, because it's Primark, let's be real. But well, I don't think that's bad at all. Beautiful. Does I have a little kick up in the pan, but doesn't seem to have fallout on my eyes, which is the most important thing, because I always do my face first. I'm gonna cut my crease and I'll be right back. That's my cut crease on, just with the lighter shade from my P. Louise. So the Rumor 00, the Rumor 0, because I figured let's give these a big chance, and we're gonna go in with this one. On, of course, my 237 brush. That is a pretty color. Let's just put this all over. And I'm enjoying myself with all this Primark stuff. It's fun. I love doing one brand full face, even though it costs me money, because like I said, I have to buy everything. And I don't know if this is for a long time already in Primark or that it's new to Primark. I think these one are quite some time there, but I love bright eyeshadows like you all know now. Let's go back in with the darker shade of the palette to blend this together. Back in with the middle shade with my M507. Quite good. I enjoy this with my Sigma E42 and do this not the same. A darker here on the corner. I think I would like to prime my products that much, but they're good. My foundation stays on nice, feels good. I'm filming for 1 hour and 45 minutes at the moment. So let's say it's on for an hour now. It's holding up good. I'm enjoying it. Doesn't feel weird or strange or annoying or anything. I did not expect it to be this nice for some reason. I don't know why. I'm going in with the same brush in the middle shade again. Just this one. To blend it all out. With a green shimmer shade, a little bit of the fallout came on my cheek. I tried to flick it away with a brush, but I can still see it a little bit. Now I'm going with a lighter shade I used before, just this one. Still with the same brush. Now I didn't use the Huda Beauty dupe thingy. I don't think it's gonna work with this, or is it? Let's make a line. Let's see what it does. We're here to try out, people. It's 8 o'clock at night. I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere anyway, but oh well. Not bad. Okay, that works. That's not bad. I think I'm gonna try the matte side once sometimes, but I'm going now in for my inner corner highlight with this gorgeous white with a green glitter in it. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that. A lot of glitter in it, but love the greeniness. A little bit more. Not bad, not bad at all. Eyeshadows on, I think. Yeah, let's put the Kohl eye pencil on my lower lash line. Aww. You can see, but my eyes is watering here. I didn't feel it, but it looks like it. Yeah, look at that. Looks fine as well. Now let's go in with my eyebrow pencil. And better quality than I thought it would be. That's not used yet. That's not used. Let's do my lower lash line first with the mascara. Let's see what the wand is. Oh, the wand is huge. I normally like them a little bit smaller. I'll be right back with my... I'm gonna use my mascara. Put my lashes on and I'll be right back with you to do my lipstick together. With this I will do just off camera. That's just a mascara on at the moment, but it's quite nice. I'm gonna put lashes on, but look, what I with, what I without. Those are my lashes on. Yeah, lashes. I had to cut off a little bit. Seem okay. Went on just fine. Yeah, nothing wrong. Now going with one of the lipsticks, and I think I'm going to go with the lightest one. I think that would be the best option for this color eye. Yeah. I don't mind it with the eyes. Or should I go darker? Well, I'm gonna put, of course, the lip gloss on top. You know, you can see the shimmer in there, just a little bit of a pinky green shimmer. Yeah, not bad. I think it looks fine. Let's put a little bit more of setting spray in while we can. Check it. Well, peeps, lovely people, that's a full face of Primark makeup on. And, lipstick on my teeth. And I like it. It feels nice on my skin, looks good on my skin. I would like to have a contour, but it's not bad. Is it the right color? Looks like the right color. Looks nice and sheen, looks quite nice. Yeah, I like it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like watching me. If you do, please subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell. Put a like in it and make me a comment if you want, or share me, or whatever you want to do, no problem. Please do, and I'll see you in the next one. And, I don't know. I liked it. I had fun with this. I don't like anything. I really like the products. I'm sorry. It worked. Maybe the blush is a little bit too pinky than I wanted to, but it worked. It wasn't too pigmented. It wasn't too bad. Am I too positive about the products I'm using? I don't know. I like them. Okay, that's annoying. Could you see that? That's not pretty. I think that's a lip gloss, but okay, I don't like the lip gloss or the lipstick. I think maybe it's a combination of it, but it looks good. Just not when I open my mouth. I don't know. Am I being too positive? I think it looks good on my skin. What do you guys think? Am I too positive? But it works so well. Or did I just buy the good stuff? I don't know. Let me know. Let me know in the comments. I'm not going to pick up the products again. You've seen me use it. You've seen me look at them. You've seen me comment on them then when I put them on. I like the look on the eyes. Lipstick is annoying, but looks good. I think it looks good. And I'll see you in the next one.